Security Bank teams up with a worldwide fund for nature to boost fund and nutrition security in Negros Occidental Province. The Foodshed Farming Enterprise Project will provide agriculture-based livelihood intervention to local communities in Kabangkalan City. It aims to promote sustainable crop and poultry production to ensure access to fresh and quality food. The program also seeks to connect farmers and fisher folk to local markets and buyers. The initiative, which also included a financial wellness workshop, was launched in early July and will run for up to 6 months. President Marcos rejects calls to suspend the controversial public transport modernization program. Marcos on Wednesday insisted the program was not rushed and that the modernization of public utility vehicles is long overdue. Majority of senators recently passed a resolution calling for the suspension of the PTMP, citing the supposed insufficiency of government's information drive, as well as the financial burden on drivers and operators to procure modern jeepneys.
I disagree with them because sinasabi nila minadali. This has been postponed 7 times. The modernization has been postponed for 7 times. And those that have been objecting or have been crying out and been asking for suspension are in the minority. 80% have already consolidated. So paano naman if yung 20% ang magde-decide yung buhay ng 100%? So pakinggan natin yung majority. At ang majority sinasabi, ituloy natin.
The Land Transport Regulator welcomes the President's commitment to the program. The LTFRB in a statement stressed the importance of modernizing the country's public transportation system.
Tech giant Microsoft turning the blame on Delta Airlines for the carrier's struggles in recovering from last month's global cyber outage. A software update by global cybersecurity firm CrowdStrike triggered system problems for millions of Microsoft customers, including airlines. The flight disruption subsided for other major U.S. carriers the next day, while Delta took several days to recover. Microsoft said Delta, unlike its competitors, apparently had not modernized its IT infrastructure. Delta denies this, saying it has invested billions of dollars in IT capital expenditures. Delta has hired prominent litigator David Boies of Boies Schiller Flexer to seek damages from both CrowdStrike and Microsoft. The Philippines' chief economist vows greater government efforts to generate high-quality jobs for Filipinos. NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan maintained Wednesday that the country's labor market remains resilient. He says the Marcos administration will continue to improve the country's business climate to attract more investments for better quality jobs. Government will also address bottlenecks to reap the benefits of its liberalization reforms. To do this, NEDA says they will enhance productivity through utilizing emerging technologies and upskilling and reskilling workers. It's also pushing for the passage of a bill which will equip Filipino students with job-ready skills.
413.9 billion pesos. That's the value of production in agriculture and fisheries in the second quarter of 2024. According to the Philippine Statistics Authority, that's a decline of 3.3% from the figure recorded in the same period last year. Crop production, particularly palay and corn, dropped by 8%, while poultry and fisheries production expanded.